So, I know it's been a while since Nintendo revealed that they're working on a new console, but I'm just going to talk about why it's not going to be any different from the Wii situation. I'm not going to get my hopes up, because I already did with the Wii U. Let me start by saying that when the Wii U was first announced, I was ecstatic. I was hyped as hell. I was on the Wii U dick riding hype train. Because at E3 2011, Nintendo made it seem like the Wii U was made, it's supposed to be a blend between casual and hardcore gamers, and they didn't appeal to either of those markets. But obviously, I didn't care about the casual bullshit, honestly. But when it comes to the hardcore gaming, I was like, oh my god, Nintendo's finally going to do it. And they didn't. It was a total flop. I'm glad I never bought a Wii U. I was thinking about, oh, you know, I might, you know, buy the console, save up money, and, you know, the game will, you know, the system will be good over years. But I forget what it was that didn't make me buy it. It was some bullshit I heard about it. I'm like, there's no way. I think it was probably launch titles that weren't that great, like Zombie U and, you know, whatever that game was called. Oh, yeah, the reskin new Super Mario Bros. Game. It had a weak launch. And I'm not saying that the PS1 and Xbox One had a particularly strong launch in comparison, but it just didn't seem anything special. The online didn't seem anything special at all. Nothing really about the Wii U made it really anything seem next gen. And that's another thing. Why would I get a next generation system if the graphics were going to be the same thing as the 360 and PS3? There's no point, right? But I thought the Wii U was going to be amazing, because they're like, oh, we're going to have Battlefield on the Wii U. I'm just laughing because that's a pipe dream, having Battlefield on the Nintendo platform. It's never going to happen. But here's why the Nintendo codename NX is not going to be any different than the Wii U in terms of lack of third-party support, even lack of first-party support. It's not going to be any different, because you think, oh, you know, people are going to be like, oh, Nintendo might learn from their mistakes on the Wii U. You really think they will? Because you really think, okay, the fact that they keep doing these antiquated business practices, that they still live in the 1990s, you really think that they're going to keep doing these practices until they just automatically stop doing these when the next Nintendo platform comes out? Recently, like I said, with my Splatoon interview, they talked about how, oh, you know, we can't have voice chat because people online are too mean. Do you really think that 2 or 3 years from now, whenever this system is going to be released, that they're going to have anything different, like their business practices? No. And here's another thing, Nintendo is basically, these days, they're basically kind of like, ignoring the importance of the hardcore gaming market, when that's the audience they tried to, oh my god, that's the audience they tried to come to when they were at E3 2011, that's the audience they kept trying to hype, you know, oh, look at our shit, you know, hardcore gamers, you guys, you know, we got Ubisoft on board, we got EA, we got all these companies and shit, you know, third-party support's happening. So how come years later they damage control having absolutely no third-party support on their platform? How come they pretend that it's not a big deal when that's what they tried to have their main selling point on the Wii U? But contrary to popular belief, you cannot have a great platform by first-party support alone. Alright, and even if that was the case, Nintendo still doesn't have a lot of third-party support, not third-party, first-party support for their Wii U. How many games has Nintendo released? First-party-wise, mean 10. Off the top of your mind, I'm sure you can't do it. I'm sure you people are gonna, like, on your Google typing up shit, you know, because you guys can't remember. I mean, sure, you guys are gonna be like, oh, Super Smash Brothers, Splatoon, Pikmin 3, right? But after that, you guys are gonna be drawing blanks. Okay, Mario Kart. After that, you guys are gonna be drawing blanks. It's been, what, 3 years? 3 years? How many exclusives Nintendo had? Really? Let's be real. And all the multiplats they've had, oh my god. The multiplats were inferior versions as well, so even if, because I remember they're like, oh, this Batman game is gonna be like the, you know, it's gonna be the definitive version on the Wii U. Well, that's not what Nintendo said, but that's what some stupid ass said on YouTube. And, oh my god, it was the worst version of Batman Arkham, whatever the hell it was. It was just a total flop. And you wanna know the main reason why there's no third-party support? Contrary to popular belief, it's not because of the graphics. Sure, eventually the graphics would prove the lack of third-party support, because, you know, what happened with the Wii. The Wii had, plenty of third-party support, but not multiplats. About it. All this third-party support, you had all these party games coming from EA and Ubisoft and blah blah blah. But when it comes to games like, let's say, Modern Warfare 2 or fucking Battlefield 3, those games weren't on the Wii. Because they couldn't handle it. The PS3 360 struggled handling Battlefield 3. Obviously, the Wii couldn't handle that shit. So, graphics, besides the point that people try to damage control saying graphics don't matter, in the long run, they really do matter. They do matter, right? If their graphics didn't matter, then we wouldn't have new consoles. If graphics didn't matter, there'd be no reason to game on a PC. Because really, what's the main thing people talk about when it comes to PC gaming? Right? But I just don't understand. They're not. This new system, the NX, is going to be the same problem. They're going to have the PS4 and Xbox One graphics as soon as the PlayStation 5 and the next Xbox are on their way. That's exactly what's going to happen, right? But people are going to keep damage controlling it, and they're going to pretend that nothing's wrong, everything's fine, and, you know, in the world of Nintendo, and, you know, the gaming market as a whole. I just don't understand. I just don't understand why people keep damage controlling. I think it's because they grew up with Nintendo all their life, and they just cannot see Nintendo not living up to their former glory. They just can't see it. They don't want to see it. They want Nintendo to prevail, but the fact is that Nintendo is hurting themselves. So, I mean, I pretty much nailed the coffin for Nintendo. There's not really much else to discuss in terms of Nintendo's next platform, and that nothing really is going to change. Nintendo has a good handheld industry going on. You know, their handhelds are pretty good, right? I mean, their handhelds are fine. 3DS is doing well. You know, they can keep doing those handhelds, but really, when it comes to home consoles, Nintendo really isn't really doing that great. And the fact that Nintendo has lost every single console war, except for the Wii 7th Gen, even though the Wii really wasn't really more of a gaming console, it was more of a toy, to be honest. But whatever, I mean, I'm not going to argue with sales numbers. The Wii technically won the 7th generation, but they lost one. Okay, they won, obviously, they won with the NES, because there wasn't really much competition. Atari was freaking on death's door. The Super Nintendo, you had Sega Genesis going on. I mean, Nintendo, I think they still won, but honestly, they had a run for their money. And they haven't really had a run for their money before that time. But as soon as the Nintendo 64 started coming in, they lost every single console. Well, they lost to Sony, and, I mean, obviously, they didn't lose to Sega, because Sega was on death's door at that time. The GameCube was dead last in the console race, due to their terrible controller design, and their graphics were a bit less capable than the PS2 was, so that's another thing. And let's see, the Wii, like I said, I'm not gonna argue, the Wii did win the console war, technically. And the Wii U, can't even, no, the Wii U is never gonna beat the PS4 or Xbox One, never. They just never will. And when it comes to the next system, PlayStation be the same like every generation. Sony beats the shit out of everyone, with Microsoft coming in right behind. Because the PS3, despite its failure of a launch, they managed to kick Microsoft's ass just by a little bit. But that little bit means a lot, considering that Microsoft had a one-year release before the PlayStation 3, and the PlayStation 3 launch was abysmal. So if it wasn't for those factors, PlayStation 3 would have, dominated. And PlayStation 2 speaks for itself, the best selling game system of all time. So, can't even go into that, but... God, that's pretty much it for this video. If you guys can try to repeat it, I mean, it's more facts versus anything else. So, yeah. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later.